Vikings, the greatest warriors ever known, feared and admired across the realm. Ready to fight once more for the glory and prosperity of their people. This particular village was home to two young Vikings, Vaskr and Odmar, destined for greatness by decree of the gods themselves. Unfortunately, the gods did not tell them of this plan. Just as he had countless times before, Odmar farewelled his parents. They always returned to him. This time was different. And the Viking warriors continued on their pillaging voyages and grew ever richer. The Viking chief was proud of his people, but he was greedy, single-minded. He wished to expand his village, regardless of the consequences. The chief despised Odmar. He never fought for his village and survived off their scraps. But the chief would tolerate this behavior no longer. Odmar would have to single-handedly loot the forest, burn it to the ground so their village may prosper. And if he refused, he would face the same fate as his old friend Vaskr. After being ridiculed by his village, Odmar ran home to his hut. Odmar felt hurt and lost. He loved his people, but he couldn't be what they wanted him to be. Perhaps he thought he wasn't a true Viking. Maybe some sleep would do him good. Odmar couldn't believe his eyes. At his side was his long-lost friend Vaskr. And in front of them stood the hallowed gates of Valhalla.
"Wait!"
cried Odmar as his old friend stepped into the light. In front of Odmar appeared a strange apparition, a forest fairy. She condemned Odmar's selfish ways and his squandered potential. He had let down those closest to him. He did not deserve a place in Valhalla. But she offered him a deal, a great power. If used correctly, perhaps he could earn his place in Valhalla, but at a price. Odmar woke up with excitement. What a strange dream. It felt so real. And how did this pouch get here? Was this what he saw in his dream? He looked inside the bag. A mushroom?
Thank you.
villagers were bewildered by the sight of Ardmar's newfound powers. Would these powers help Ardmar redeem himself as a Viking? Perhaps Ardmar could become a great warrior just as his friend Vaska was. But is destroying the forest the right thing to do? There was loud commotion in the crowd.
Ardmar!
Roared the chief. You dare to bring this cursed magic to our village? This is a new low. Death on the battlefield is too noble a fate for you. Perhaps the Kraken should teach you a lesson at the bottom of the sea. You can't hide from the gods, Ardmar! The chief bellowed as Ardmar leapt away. The skies turned dark. Thunder struck. Suddenly, the villagers vanished. Ardmar was shocked. Who took his people? Was it the gods? Why was he left behind? He had to find out.
Thank you.
Admar wasn't used to days like this. What was he even fighting for? If he somehow retrieved his villages, would the chief still cast him out? Maybe, if he could capture the one responsible. Perhaps they'd forgive him for his life and cowardice. Goblin, shouted Admar. Why are you watching me? I have questions for you.
The creature bolted away, and Admar's attention turned to a wild boar.
Please, noble beast, pleaded Admar. Help me catch that monster. Admar had found a great friend in the boar. Even though they'd lost track of the goblin, the boar had given him more help than anyone in recent years. Just as Oddmar bid his new friend farewell, suddenly, the fairy from his dream appeared.
I didn't grant these powers so you could spend your days chasing monsters,
said the fairy pointedly. Oddmar was surprised and said,
I thought you only existed in my dream.
I gave you these powers for a reason, said the fairy. We need your help, Oddmar.
Help with what?
Oddmar asked reluctantly.
My people are gone. I need to find them.
You have to save the forest, said the fairy.
You have to restore balance to the world.
Restore balance? Oddmar started, but he was interrupted by a loud growl emanating from the forest.
You have to hurry, said the fairy. We don't have much time, Oddmar.
And in a flash, she was gone. Troll, and it was right in Oddmar's path. He needed to pass it in order to enter the forest. Oddmar was careful not to wake the troll, but it was too late.
You dare set foot in my forest?
Roared the troll.
I am the protector of this forest.
This is a dream. Go back to sleep,
Oddmar urged.
A dream,
replied the troll.
No. Oh, no. For you, it shall be a nightmare. You shall pay for what your kind has done to our home.
Thank you.
Ardmar had to admit it. Without that strange monster he'd be chasing, he was lost.
Ardmar,
the creature whispered as he snuck up at him from behind. Ardmar was startled, but quickly slammed the creature to the ground. He had finally caught the creature and demanded, "Tell me where you've taken my people, goblin!"
"Do I look like a goblin to you?"
the creature replied. Ardmar became even more enraged.
"Okay, okay.
Look," the creature said nervously.
"I don't know where they've taken him, and I don't know who did it. I don't know why you would even care. There's an elder deep in the forest. He knows everything that happens here. If they're in the forest, he'll know. Just down the river."
"All right. But if you're lying, you know I can catch you again," said Ardmar as he released the creature.
Ah!
by King Hutt. It was strange there was one so deep in the forest.
Could this be the place the goblins spoke of?
Perhaps inside there were answers. The hut was abandoned. All that remained was a book. Although Ardmar was never one for reading, he opened it. Inside the book it read, Diary of Vaskar. The disgraced.
Could his old friend still be alive?
With Ardmar's parents gone, Vaskar took Ardmar in.
Despite this huge responsibility at such a young age, Vaskar had impressed the chief and become a promising young warrior.
The chief was so impressed, he decided Vaskar was to lead the Vikings into the forest for the first time.
Vaskar went to the forest alone to prepare.
But the more he went out there, the less he wanted to hurt anything within it.
He begged the chief to reconsider. But the chief was not a very thoughtful man.
When Vaskar refused to lead the charge, he was labeled a traitor and was banished.
Much time passed, and a fairy visited Vaskar.
A great threat to the forest was looming,
and her people were in danger.
She knew she could trust him with the great power to save the forest.
He had no idea he was to fight the God of Chaos.
Vaskar was almost victorious. But Loki, in desperation, turned Vaskar's own powers against him.
He was cursed.
But Loki was driven from the forest.
For now.
The curse was quickly consuming Vaskar. But the fairy could not help.
Loki's hold on the forest and their magic was still too tight.
The fairy asked if there was anyone else who could help.
Vaskar was reluctant to put his friend in danger, but he had no choice.
Ardmar always asked himself why he never went out there, why he was too scared to try and help his friend as he had helped him.
He often thought about that, but where was Vaskar now? Perhaps his aunt lay further down the river.
Hey!
The cranky elder had been woken up by Admar, and was eager to get back to sleep.
"I'm sorry I woke you up," said Admar, "but I need your help to find my people."
"The gods entrusted the forest to your people," the elder replied, "but you destroy it for your own gain. Why should I, the great elder of the forest, help you?"
Admar didn't know how to respond, and felt ashamed.
"The forest goblin,"
Admar uttered.
"He told me that you had answers. Please help me."
The elder paused. He knew that the creature Admar was referring to had made a great sacrifice to protect the forest. He decided to help Admar.
"Underneath the great mountain, there is a powerful golem," explained the elder. "It will not help you willingly, but it has the key to the gate between worlds."
Admar's spirits were lifted, and asked the elder,
"Between worlds? Will I find my people there? Do you know where Vaskar is?"
The elder yawned, closed his eyes, and muttered,
"I grow tired, Viking. I'm not used to speaking this much."
The elder fell into a deep slumber, and Admar was on his way
Ardmar ventured deeper into the forest and encountered a band of goblins holding a forest critter prisoner. Although his greatest challenge lay ahead in that mountain, and he was resolved to stay in his path, he knew that helping that poor critter was the right thing to do.
"Come, new friend!"
he shouted as he smashed the cage and freed the prisoner. The squirrely creature was thankful. In return, he agreed to help the Viking along his journey.
Thank you.
thanked the squirrel, he had taken him very far. Perhaps he could find help in his village. The village was deserted. Could Ardmar be the last Viking in all of the land? If he failed, would he be destined to walk alone until the end of his days? Ardmar had heard stories as a child of the beast of legend that lurked below the water. But unless disturbed, that is where it would stay. The crash! It was real! Perhaps the chief's wish would come true.
Ardmar's senses had sharpened throughout his journey. He could feel someone was watching him.
I know you're there, goblin, said Ardmar firmly.
I am not a goblin, Ardmar,
said the creature and sighed.
I may look like this now,
but there was a time when you and I were not that different.
It couldn't be, could it?
Not only had this creature been helping him all along, but this creature was, in fact, his oldest friend.
Vaskar?
The creature protested, but it was no use. Ardmar had many questions for his oldest friends, and many stories he wished to relive. Of the time they chased chickens thinking they were small dragons, or pretended to be the chief so they could steal desserts. Ah, to have found friendship again, so many years after being alone.
With a sense of shame, Vaskar looked down and said,
I'm not Vaskar anymore. I've not been since I was cast out. Now I'm even less. I didn't want to tell you because I didn't want you to see me like this.
Stop it!
Ardmar interrupted.
You should have told me. It's okay, I know what's happened to you. But this time,
You're not alone. Together, we can save the forest and save our people.
The two friends were reunited, and although their quest was far from over, their spirits were high. Could it be that all was not as bleak as it once appeared?
Oh,
The two friends continued further through the forest, getting closer towards the end of their journey.
What was it like to fight the God of Chaos?
Asked Admar.
Oh, we do not speak of him,
replied Vaska.
He's vain. He loves the stories people tell of him. The words call to him.
Admar turned to his friend and said, I'm not afraid of Loki. Thunderstruck, and the fairy appeared.
Fairy,
said Admar.
The Elder told me I needed to ascend a mountain to retrieve a key. A key that opens a gate between worlds.
The fairy paused, her expression twisting. Something was wrong.
The Elder lied to you,
said the fairy.
The only way out of this world is death.
This is not the fairy,
Vaska shouted. Admar stood fast. He would not act.
It's time for you to join your fellow warriors.
The fairy roared in a dark voice. The fairy's eyes turned green, and a bolt of lightning extended towards Admar. But Vaska leapt in front of his friend, shielding Admar from the magic. And once again, Admar had lost his oldest friend.
Vaska, always the hero, wasn't he?
The fairy said nefariously.
I will not give you the honor of joining our friends. I will curse you, just as I cursed Vaska.
Admar was enraged, but did not know what to do.
I too am cursed, Admar,
the fairy continued.
My curse is not to sit alongside my fellow gods. They do not accept me, but I aspire to even greater heights. Your people will help me. They will break through the gates of Valhalla for me, so that I may take my rightful place. I am the greatest god, for I am the god of chaos. I am Loki.
In a flash, Loki was gone.
What was that? Ah!
Admar scaled the cliff, alone. His allies were gone, and his heart was broken. Yet he continued to push forward. Loki's curse. It was real. Just as it turned Vaska, it too would turn him. He would fail the forest and his village. Perhaps, he thought, the world was better off with no Vikings in it. But he would not have to fight alone. For in front of him, he saw a familiar pair of tusks which he didn't expect this far up a mountain. Perhaps all was not lost.
Wow!
planet, he had reached the cave the Elder had told him of. He would soon have to face the golem. The fairy was waiting for him at the entrance.
"You've proved yourself," said the fairy. "You've passed the test. I'll return Vaskar to you, and you can rebuild your village free of that tyrant chief and those who judged you so harshly."
Oddmar knew this was not the fairy. This was just another deceitful trick by Loki. He was not fooled. Loki shifted into his true form, and menacingly said,
"I guess my trick didn't work. You're not as dumb as you look. But then again, maybe the pig is the brains of this operation."
With Loki distracted by the sound of his own voice, his guard was down. This was Oddmar's chance. Oddmar and his trusted companion charged towards Loki, but quickly struck down by a bolt of lightning that reflected off Oddmar's shield. With the influence of his power, Loki was confident that Oddmar would stand no chance against the golem. He used his magic to wake the ancient golem, and left Oddmar to fight for his life.
Thank you.
was over. Odmar had won. Weary but resolved, he had found the shiny red gem that was the key to saving his people. Odmar held the key up high and waited for something to happen, but quickly realized he didn't know how to use it. Suddenly, a vicious band of goblins swooped down on Odmar. He struggled to hold on to the key, but there were too many goblins. Odmar was overwhelmed. They snatched the key and ran away. Goblins. Their treachery had no limits.
Ah! Was despaired and lost. He wondered what Vaskar would have done in his place. As he thought about this, the fairy appeared by his side. With a heavy heart, the fairy told him,
"I'm sorry that I put this burden on you. The fate of the forest and the fate of your people is now in Loki's hands."
Odmar disheartenedly said,
"Loki's curse is consuming my strength. I grow weaker by the day. Loki still has the key, and I don't know where he is."
The fairy looked toward Odmar and said,
"Loki has taken the key to the edge of the world. There the key can be used to open a portal between worlds. Your people are trapped there."
Odmar knew what he had to do. He had to get to the edge of the world, and he had to face Loki and finish what Vaskar had started. The fairy's magic was fading, and she used the last of her powers to summon a guiding spirit for Odmar.
Yeah. Ha ha!
still and quiet in the chamber. No more goblins. No more monsters. Just silence.
The beautiful man-made carvings giving way to the natural forest and its magic. Here was the uneasy place where the world joined. It was as if gods knew one day there would be a just cause for a mortal to travel beyond this place. Odd felt at home here. He had spent his life torn between the world in his own head and the world of Vikings. This was a place of compromise. Maybe his people could learn from this. Maybe they would no longer destroy and take. Maybe he could truly save them. Not just from death, but from themselves.
Loki emerged in front of the gate and said,
Are you here to join your friends, Viking?
I'd use someone like you in my army.
I will never join you!
Like my cry out as he charged towards Loki.
He was ready to fight.
Do you even think your people want to be saved by you?
Said Loki with a mocking smile.
They will march into the army of the God of Chaos!
They will be known as the ones who broke down the gates of Valhalla!
No more lies!
Ardmar bellowed.
He would not be manipulated.
I have never told you a lie!
Said Loki confidently.
I'm simply predicting your future!
Ah!
done it.
But he did not know what waited for him behind that door.
He would soon find out. His villagers looked broken and lost of all hope.
They were astonished at the sight of Odmar. They had misjudged him. They had not believed in him.
But they would never doubt him again.
Vaskar!
Said Odmar as he embraced his old friend.
Your curse has been lifted! I barely recognize you!
Aye, said Vaskar. Now with Loki defeated, the fairy regained her strength.
The fairy came forth and said,
You have done well, Odmar. Take this. It shall lift your curse.
Consider it a thank you gift from the forest.
Balance and order had been restored. Odmar was no longer cursed.
As he regained his strength, he realized that for the first time in life, he believed in himself.
In front of the gates of Valhalla, he looked up in awe, wondering if his parents were proud of him.
Odmar was not ready to meet them, not just yet, but he hoped he'd earned a place by their side.
He had become a true Viking.